So my birthday party is over now. And I think I shall serve you something. So it's supernatural you want her. Well, no, let's see. I've got the recipe. But mummy story, tuck your shrouds under your chins, fasten your drew cups, and feast on the fall fair I'd call. Since it's the last younger in this issue, this wraps it up. Egyptian sun blazed down upon the three archaeologists, sucking the perspiration from their pores and sending it in tiny streams down their faces. They worked feverishly, first one, then the other, digging into the burning sand at the base of the towering glyph.
To be here. It's got to. Every shred of evidence we've pieced together says this is the spot.
Do not be disappointed if it's not Arnold. We have been wrong before. Why don't you rest now? Remember your heart.
Dr. Arnold Munson sat down and wiped his soaking wet face with his handkerchief. He studied his two associates, Professor Thomas Steele and Dr. Jerome Grable, as they continued digging.
Here we are, on the verge of the most valuable archaeological find of the century, and I have to watch my heart. Ugh.
You were advised not to even go along this expedition, Arnold. No less dig like that.
Bah! I am as healthy as a 20-year-old, just because I had a slight heart attack.
Another heart attack could be fatal, Arnold. Get that through your stubborn, thick skull.
Come, Arnold, look!
Dr. Jerome Gravel pointed at the spot where they'd been digging.
What is it, Jeremy?
You found something!
The entrance! The entrance to the tomb!
At the bottom of the excavation was a round iron ring embedded in a huge partially uncovered slab of stone.
Give me a shovel, let me!
I'll finish uncovering the slab.
Soon the stone block and had been fully cleared of sand. As Arnold anxiously watched, Thomas and Jerome tucked at it.
Coming loose, I'll give you a hand.
A little more.
Finally, the large stone slab was swung away, revealing a dark opening with dusty steps descending into the blackness. The musty odor of decay and rot of things long buried and air-free, 1,000 years old seared their nostrils.
We found it! The tomb of Ikabukama, 5th pharaoh of Egypt!
Footsteps echoed into the cavernous blackness, shattering the silence of centuries, flickering light from the lantern tomb's garish walls that had not felt light for over 100 generations. The three men descended into the shaft.
I've counted 55 steps already.
We're nearing the bottom.
The steps ended before a small door. Its surface was exquisitely decorated with typical examples of Egyptian artistry. Over the door was a tablet inscribed with hieroglyphics.
What does it say, Thomas? You're the hieroglyphics expert.
Yes, one moment. It says, beyond this door lies exalted Ikamukama, 5th pharaoh of all Egypt. Let this be a warning to all who trespass. Death will come to those who enter his tomb. Ikamukama will rise to avenge the disturbance of his sanctity.
Jerome's laughter was thin and tinged with nervousness. It rippled through the silence and echoed up the stairs of the shaft.
Typical of the warnings placed at the entrance to other Pharaoh's tombs.
They were supposed to scare off wandering bands of thieves.
Arnold tried to push the door open.
It's sealed! Hey!
We'll have to smash it. Lend a hand here, Jeremy. Step away, Arnold.
Flinging their full weight against the sealed tomb entrance door, Dr. Gabriel and Professor Steele finally managed to break it down.
Look! On the floor!
Skeletons!
The widened skulls grinned up at them, as if they each enjoyed a secret they would not share.
Perhaps these are the remains of thieves who at once broke in.
The door was sealed!
Then who are they?
Workmen, perhaps. Servants who injured Ikakuhama and then were murdered so that the secret of the top's location would be kept.
Jules! Jules! Arnold, Jeremy, come see! Good lord, a fortune in precious stones!
Professor Thomas Steele scooped up handfuls of the sparkling gems hungrily.
Rubies, emeralds, sapphires, millions of dollars worth.
Hold them, a solid gold!
Yes!
The greatest archaeological discovery of the 20th century, I said it.
Take
would
it easy,
be.
Arnold. Don't excite yourself. Remember your heart.
Here! In here! It's the burial chamber!
The sarcophagus of Ikamukama!
Thomas, help me lift the lid!
Get that end, Jeremy.
The lid of the sarcophagus was removed, revealing the mummy of Ikamukama.
Perfectly preserved.
What a find! We must get a message back to the museum!
Thomas stared at Arnold.
But... if we report that we've found the tomb, we'll have to turn the treasure over to them.
Why, of course, Thomas. It belongs to them.
But we found it. We sweated and burned out in that hot sun until we discovered it. Isn't it right, Jeremy?
Thomas, I'm ashamed of you. Of course the treasure belongs to the museum.
Jerome took Thomas by the arm and jerked him into a corner.
Shut up, you fool! Can't you see how it's too righteous to claim the treasure for himself?
Then we've got to get rid of him. He stands in our way.
Later that night in the camp of a free archaeologist near the entrance to the tomb.
Is he asleep?
Yes. Now this is what you do. Go down into the tomb, unwrap the mummy of Ikamukama, and wrap yourself in its windings. Then shout or scream. I will awaken Arnold and tell him that you must be down there. When we reach the burial chamber, you go into a mummy act, and I will start shouting about the curse.
I get it. His heart. He'll drop dead of fright.
Exactly. And when we bring his body back to Cairo, we'll claim he had a heart attack from disappointment over the failure of our expedition.
And the treasure will be ours.
All right, go ahead and hurry.
Wait for my shout.
Thomas went down into the tomb. Jerome sat in his cot for a long time, growing more and more uneasy finally.
What's that?
Arnold sat bolt upright on his cot. Jerome leaped to his feet. Thomas' blood-curdling scream came again.
It's Thomas! His bed's empty! He must be down there!
Let's go!
In the tomb! He must be in trouble!
Hurry, Arnold! Hurry!
Suddenly, they reached the treasure chamber. Thomas' lamp sat up on the floor, illuminating the entire room. The beyond was a barrel chamber, Arnold stopped.
Oh my lord, look!
It's the mummy!
Came from the barrel chamber, shambling along, tottering weakly. His windings hanging loosely. Jerome had to control himself to keep from laughing. Thomas looked so comical. Then Jerome went into his act.
The curse, Arnold! The curse on the entrance door!
Death will come to those who enter his door. Ikakuhamo will rise.
Wretched feature stumbled forward.
The curse is true, Arnold! The mummy has risen!
Jerome, I...
It was almost upon them.
Arnold, come on! Let's run!
Jerome, my...
Arnold crumbled to the floor. Jerome knelt to explain him.
He's dead.
Jerome began to laugh. The ramp features stopped.
Good work, Thomas. Good work. Just one thing.
Jerome drew a pistol from under his shirt.
One thing you didn't count on, Thomas. You see, I want that treasure for myself. Thanks for your help.
Jerome fired at the swaying feature before him. Bullet tore through the fabric, but the feature did not fall.
For God's sake, I shot you, Thomas! Die! Die!
Jerome backed off, emptying his gun into the winding encased feature. But the mummy kept coming. Jerome backed into the burial chamber. The sarcophagus was open.
Good lord!
The man in the mummy case had a look of sheer horror on his face.
Thomas, it's you?
The mummy was right behind Jerome, almost touching him.
Thomas, then, who's that?
Ah! Hey, come on, what's this fucking name to care of the disturbers of his sanctity, as the curse had predicted? After that, he tossed the bodies on the pile with the other skeletons, yawned, shut with the front slab once more, and went back to sleep. Well, my cauldron will be popping next time in the Vault of Horror. Bye now.